What's up, everybody? PG Braun here, president of Blackstone Labs and Celestial Bodiez.
And two separate but equal fan clubs, the TT fan club and the Tater fan club. And I'm Celeste, CEO of Celestial Bodiez, wifey, Instagram liver.
People are watching. This is how we do it. This is the real deal. So while we are recording this, we are on Instagram Live. It's the first time we've ever done this, probably the last. So we're going to go back to December 19th. And I had a kid, Aaron, that I trained with. He is a Marine, and he's a very loyal Blackstone customer, and he was in town for one day. And he really wanted to train with me. And usually when I train with people, I just kill them, because even though I'm all old and broken, I can still whoop these little kids' ass. But this kid, he was like the Terminator. And
you wouldn't think it by looking at him.
Well, you just finished like boot camp and stuff, so he was in impeccable shape. So we were doing all this high rep leg stuff, and I was like dying. And I would be like, "Are you tired?" And he'd be like, "No, sir." And I'd be like, "God damn."
He's like, "Why?"
You already started?
I just warming up with some squats.
Oh, all right, cool. So if you want to just do my routine with me, we'll do the whole video and everything.
Sure. Yeah,
it'll be cool. We'll because I got the whole the BPJ version 2 coming up in January.
Yeah.
So this will probably be like the actual like last video I do before we start that. Awesome. This will be like the fattest that everybody sees me in this video.
All right, fantastic.
Cool. Okay, cool. Well, I'll have you just follow my lead and we'll just fly through it. I'm not the man I used to be, so don't judge me.
Some deadlifts, and I'll go do leg extension, leg curls on dunks. I'm training for powerlifting.
Yeah, it's much different.
So yeah.
I trained like that for many, many years now. It's all like volume and pace based.
Yeah.
But it's good for you. It's good to switch up. You'll feel good when you get to your next one.
Oh yeah, makes sense.
And Sammy and Lewis speak really highly of you, so.
Well, I've been doing business with Lewis now for 3 years almost.
Yeah.
It's been fantastic, man. Guys provide great customer service. You got great products, and literally that's like the main selling points that I give to other guys. So like, they're gonna take care of you. You know, yeah. They know the product, they know what they're selling, you know, and they use the stuff themselves.
Where exactly do you live?
I'm stationed in Camp Pendleton.
Okay. Yep.
So my parents live in Alabama, so
okay.
Headed there tomorrow. But yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, no, got a lot of guys using the stack now. Talking to a guy, he's in Spain right now.
Just by like San Diego, right?
Yep.
Yeah. Yep. I was out there for a little while.
Yeah. Yeah. Did you live up in LA or more than San Diego?
I lived in LA for a little while and I hated LA. And then I was down in San Clemente.
Yeah, that's so, where Pendleton's at.
Yeah, I used to train in Worlds in San Diego, and then yep. There was this gym called Metrics Gym in Costa Mesa. I don't know if it's still there. But one of my old clients was like in charge of the gyms on Camp Pendleton. Her name was Sabrina Taylor. I don't know if she's still there or not. But she was like in charge of all the actual gyms.
Yeah.
So I've actually been on base before. And I've been in two of the different gyms, actually, that they have stationed on base. One of them is pretty big, actually. It's pretty impressive. It's definitely better than this. But that was back in like 2011, you know, so I don't know how things are now.
Yeah, I actually do the report in 2012, so
oh, cool.
I wouldn't have been there.
Yeah, so I was already gone. Yeah, I moved here in 2012. So.
Okay. Yeah, that's awesome. Yeah, and I'm looking forward after this powerlifting competition. I'll probably start hitting more stuff like this because it's good for the endurance.
Switch it up, man. It's good to be back and forth. How old are you?
22.
You're so young, you just want to, you know, learn what your body responds to best, keep giving yourself variety, listen to your body when you have aches and pains, and when you're young, it's fun to, like, push yourself through pain, but when you get older, you realize that that's not the smartest thing to do.
Yeah.
Pain is just your body saying, hey, don't do that anymore.
Right.
Most of the really good powerlifters will say that they wish that they listened to their bodies more as older guys. I mean, I can tell you from all the aches and pains and bumps and bruises I have, and both torn biceps. And fortunately, my knees are pretty good for the most part. I got really bad shoulders, herniated disc in my back that aggravates me every now and then. But that's all just from like going too hard and too heavy, you know? So you gotta always, even if you're training for your powerlifting, like afterwards, cycle into stuff like this so your body can chill, you know? Take that time. You'll make way better, you know, gains and strength gains and size gains as well. Doing it that way, so.
Yes.
Awesome.
Great.
Yeah, it was a pleasure, man. Get yourself some food and have a safe flight also.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you for the business, too.
Yep, no problem.
And I was so sore after that workout. It was the hardest I've trained.
For like 5 days.
It was the hardest I've trained in a long time. So that kid is the Terminator. So Aaron Keen, I believe, is his last name. He is actually the Terminator. The T-1000. December 20th, I got the Hellcat back. So the Hellcat is now made into a official Blackstone Labs Hellcat. It is all blacked out, murdered out, as they say. Looks pretty amazing.
Yes. I'm just looking for you.
Awesome.
Really nice.
You see how they did this? I think this is really cool. So originally I wanted the body to be gloss, and the guy was like, straight up, he was like, look, he goes, it's your car, you can do whatever you want. He was like, but it looks so mean right now. He's like, aesthetically, it's not gonna look right with the gloss body, with the satin top. He was like, but, he's like, I wanna try something, I've never even done this before, I think it would look neat. He was like, we could run a gloss strip down the top panel. He goes, and I will get I'll get the JPEG of your logo, and we'll have the machine cut it out and lay it on here so the satin comes out. And it looks really, really neat. So when the light hits it, especially this side, you can see the way the light's hitting it more. Let me get out of the way. So that's the satin underneath. So normally we do the stickers. This is just a piece of the wrap that's on top of it. These guys did a really good job.
Hi, man.
You see the Hellcat?
I didn't like see it up close. It's freaking
sick. Scary.
Did you drive it?
Not yet. I gotta drive it over to Excel to get the plate for it. It's sick. It's piss.
It's revolting.
It's revolting. It's insulting.
It's so awesome.
So look at.
This isn't as noticeable as I thought it'd be.
This side, you can't see as much. It's just because where the sun is. Look at on this side. How cool.
It looks so sick.
That's way, way better than a sticker.
Mm-hmm.
Look at this, Josh, on this side.
Yes.
You see it?
The sun, the way the sun hits this, how they cut this out.
You see it?
Do you see it?
Damn.
I'm black.
Stand where I am and look down the strip.
Do a sexy pose.
How they cut,
it.
They cut the our logo out of the gloss so that the satin would be out underneath. That's not a sticker. They put the wrap over the gloss
so
and sick. Cut it out.
I didn't know that.
The guy had said that he'd never even done that before. He wanted to try it.
Have you seen with the wraps when they do? They put like the
so cool.
It's like a foam sticker logo underneath the wrap, so it looks raised off of the wrap.
No,
it's
I'll
the
have
dopest
to check that
thing
out.
Ever. That's
maybe
what I want
to
do for my Blackstone logos on my car.
This
we smoked these lights were just regular clear. So we smoked them and put a little red inside them. And then we did, these are the legal tints.
I'm sorry for
the
overreacting.
You go darker
you
than that, you're getting pulled over.
Sorry for overreacting. That's like my response to everything that I overreact to.
And that is the, like, there's a, like that's our logo and
yeah,
that's,
they cut
the,
it out.
That's the car.
Cool?
Like that.
And then look, they took
that's
the
ridiculous.
Helmet
off,
which was chrome and made it black.
I like the logo on the front bumper.
And I don't know what they're doing to the door outside, but it's annoying. They're shaking it.
No, the codes got changed, so no one
knows how to get in.
And so they're just like banging on the door all day. I couldn't remember mine either.
I wish that we did not change the codes, because I don't know my code either.
I think I know mine.
However, I was smart enough to press the doorbell rather than just keep violently shaking the door like the other people.
Oh my God.
Eric is going to go and make them stop while we're recording this. All right, so there is a hole in the...
Lewis is yelling at everyone.
There is a hole in the door of the Muscle Boys room, and it's become a mystery of how this door got broken.
It can't get close enough.
We'll go from the side.
PJ,
is there a different chair?
I want to give him 45% off.
The only difference. Yeah, that one's different. That one's different.
I want to give him 45% off on everything.
All right. You know, just so you know, Chris was going to go real hard in January.
Yeah. Well, then that'll leave me some room to like deal with and push him.
Okay.
If I'm at 50, then I have no like.
Okay. Room to wait. You can do what you want. So not in this one either, right?
No, not possible.
There's no way they can get there like that.
That's a knee.
That's to me, like.
That's a knee, bro.
You need it. Like perfect, dude. Like that.
There's a crack here. Which, if
no, that's a door. That way,
if you came out this way, like mm-hmm. say the door was shut and someone went to like
knee it,
it might have cracked that.
Yeah.
Because these doors are like garbage.
It's definitely not from the chair.
No.
The mystery continues.
It's a 6-inch knee left.
Yeah.
Somebody needed something.
Shit. Each chair, there's different chairs in there. We lined up all the chairs, and that's not that smart.
So why don't we put an email blast out with a reward?
We'll give them a free bottle of booze.
Fuck. We got plenty of that. Why didn't you just tell the truth?
Somebody was probably drunk and did something stupid, and they're probably really embarrassed.
You think it happened at the holiday party?
It
wasn't there Monday, right?
Well, it's on the cameras there now, so we're not worried about it.
I didn't notice it when I was here Sunday.
I didn't notice it on Monday.
I personally don't even remember seeing it on Monday either.
I do not remember it from Monday.
I can tell you. But.
No, it happened last night. Like Matt said something happened last night. He said, it was the chair.
But it's definitely not the chair.
It's obviously
the entire office is investigating the door incident.
PJ, Eric.
What was the, there was any sort of like scuffle or argument between anybody in there last night?
I exploded before I left, but that was like at 5:00.
Who did you yell at?
I yelled at everyone and everyone.
Yeah, is there anyone that has a bad temper that would be like, mad that you yelled at them and like need the door or something?
Can you handle this?
Think about it. We all wear shorts.
Someone's probably gonna have marks on their knee.
If they need it, right?
So like we have to line up all the Muscle Boys' knees.
They're hot heads. There's a group of hot heads amongst them. Yes.
Police liner.
But I would be embarrassed if I was a hothead and only broke the door that much.
Yeah.
So you want me to get 14?
Seems like broken and then like
something that was like, I'm assuming unintentional.
I feel like you were carrying something.
I told Matt, I'm like, dude, we're not even mad. We think it's fucking hilarious.
So
I just feel like if someone was carrying something, they tried to open the door.
There's a hole in the door.
He said he'll be here soon to reenact it.
And so
he promises he's legit.
So Grant from marketing, who's very smart, did some like a whole CSI investigation and mm-hmm. used like, I don't know, math. He used math to calculate what caused the hole in the door.
We did numerous tests of chairs sliding and things and that.
Knees.
We don't know who did it.
We don't know who did it.
The keys didn't get cracked at all. There he is. He walked in just in time.
I came for you guys. No, look.
So,
sorry.
This hole can't have been made with this crack unless there was some kind of force on this doorknob to cause the door to crack along this level of the doorknob. So So if you have your hand on the doorknob and do this, you're going to be pulling the doorknob.
If I try to fucking kick that door, it would be down.
You're going to be. You're going to be pulling.
I'll do it right now if you want me to show you, like, in all honesty.
No,
I did this. Look, get the fuck out of the way, Grant. CSI, bro.
You see this?
I kicked off of the wall thinking it would be strong enough. Because I rolled out this way because someone had to go, and I literally went, okay, I could go back to my desk, kicked off of it, and it kicked into the wall. That's how you have this half thing, Grant, right here. Because this impacted this. Boom, fuck all you guys.
CSI,
CSI. It literally is
CSI Boca Raton.
The door would have had to already be against the wall when you kicked it. Because
do you want me to get everyone in the fucking call center to tell you how it went down?
You're not
going
to be able to put a hole in the door while it's adrift.
I'll show you that.
So it hit, and then...
You would have had to hit it while it's already against the surface to put a hole in it.
But isn't that what he said he did?
Yes, but Grant wants to tell me that I'm wrong, so fuck it.
No, that's what Grant. Oh.
My goal was to determine who did it, and now we know who did it.
You're like, that was a trap.
Somebody's getting CSI Miami. Awesome.
This place is hilarious. This is ridiculous.
He didn't even break the
He's
door
as strong
door.
As we he is.
Fuck everything. Fuck you, Jack. Bro. I'm so upset.
We're just trying to get him to break it the whole way.
I will do it if you want. I'll show you what I'm
doing. No one wants you to do that. No one.
December 21st was Eric's birthday. Happy birthday to Eric, belated.
Yay.
A little surprise for him.
Making everyone go in there and record himself?
Eric, are you recording yourself? Do you want me to record?
I'll just do it.
I can, oh God. To be fair, she can afford to place it.
You need to hold the bottom of it, honey, if you hold the lens.
Cup it?
You cup the lens.
Cup the lens. Cupping it.
You cup the lens and then you work the microphone shaft.
And... 3, 2, 1.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Eric. Happy birthday to you.
See Eric's passport picture?
I still think you should have made Eric videotape it himself.
I did. I just took it from him. We were going to do that.
Yeah, it would have been so funny. It would have been like POP cake eating. POP cake eating.
Right?
Sounds so
there's a festival.
How long ago was that?
I was 17.
Oh, you're actually Google.
They said open your eyes.
Okay.
Which means it's expired now, too. If this was at 17.
It's got like 6 months left.
So.
You turned 27 today?
Yeah, 10 years on that
yes,
thing.
Yes, 27.
Big 27. Also, look at your twin behind you.
Oh, man.
You guys should have to fight because you dress alike.
And we gave out the holiday bonuses this year, all the same time.
Also, since everybody is in the room at the same time, I'm going to hand out everybody's Christmas cards or holiday cards. So, and Savina will check off the list, make sure that I... We got everybody.
Don't double.
All right. Let's see. Let's go. Should I call people up or should I actually just walk around?
Call it.
Probably call people up. Austin.
Annika, 7 for Annika.
Hit
him
out.
Smelling out some medical ores.
I'm 7
a.m. Where's Marchetti?
I'm right here. Nope.
Is it Marchetti or Marchetti?
Marchetti.
Thank you.
Wait, is it Marchetti?
Let's call him Machete.
I've been calling you Marchetti for like years.
A lot of people have been calling him
it's Marchetti.
Yeah.
Now we're just
saying everybody's way too late in the game,
including you.
I gave up on yours a little
bit. I've just never corrected anybody.
Marchetti.
It's Marchetti, right?
Yeah, but I'm saying his nickname is Marchetti.
Lewis. Where are you?
Alright, I'm not gonna cut this, but here's what I'm
gonna do. Cut the cake.
Thank you.
That's what you want.
I want that piece with the Oreo right there.
Alright.
Thanks, PJ.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you, PJ. Thank you.
So, fuck all you guys for taking all my money. And December 22nd. It's a lot of banter. Celeste and I were actually flying out of town.
Oh yeah, we weren't there.
Yeah, that was Secret Santa day. So.
They were supposed to FaceTime us during Secret Santa, but
nope.
There was an incident.
We'll call that banter Secret Santa day.
So like I walked out and I came back and he was still doing sales and I was like, wow, this kid's a hustler. And then people started sending me screenshots of his puke. And
I was like, he's probably so embarrassed. Because he was like, yeah, man. He's like, because he was like, do you want to do a shot of Bacardi with me? And I was like, nah, I don't drink Bacardi. I haven't had Bacardi since I was fucking 17.
Yeah, but they cracked open.
Like, congratulations for drinking what 17-year-olds drink. You're probably open. Less than 21.
They cracked open that bottle of Kettle One. We all did shots when me and Kasha got
yeah,
there.
Yeah, well, I did shots with Melissa the other night. Adults drink things like Kettle One. Children drink things like Bacardi. So I knew, like, something bad. At least it wasn't Bacardi Limon, because then it would smell real bad.
Oh.
Have you and Celeste have a chance to talk about whether or not you want to do an end of the year sale for CB?
We have not, although I think we are. There's a Blackstone sale coming Monday. It's an athlete's flash sale.
Okay.
And it's perfect timing, right after Christmas. I think they're going to superimpose like Santa hats and all the hats, right?
Yeah,
working on that. We can do something similar with CB for sure.
Do we have a New Year's Day slash Eve sale?
Please don't.
I haven't thought about that because I feel like, bless you.
God damn it.
I feel like New Year's Eve, everybody is like hustling around, figuring out their plans.
I will be hunched over a toilet seat more than likely.
Well, it's that's like
one. It's the one day of the year I drink. It's my birthday, so I drink.
When's your birthday?
January 1st.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
How about that?
I get to avoid the office for my birthday.
First of the year, baby. I have one other friend, Filippiano, who's the first of the year, baby. He's a good
thing. You know, we always, on purpose, never acknowledge him on his birthday.
Yeah, it's great. Yeah. I love it.
Everybody else is acknowledging the new year.
Yeah.
Maybe we'll do a Chris Heron sale then instead.
God, no.
We'll just not acknowledge the new year at all. We'll do something funny with his face. Maybe we'll do that.
Oh my God, no.
No, you deserve this because now you've messed
and
up.
And do like that Chris Heron sale.
Beginning of the year. You deserve
When I posted in the shirt, people were like, that's a far less creative shirt than you guys have done before. And I was like, you fucking idiots don't know.
No idea.
The inside joke. So maybe we'll do something stupid like that.
I like that. The coupon code will be Aiden.
Sorry.
Come on.
We can do most creative customer service complaint. He'll be the one to fix it and you'll also get a prize.
Yeah, that's actually a great idea.
The best
like that.
Customer service
my
email.
Idea, not Clay's. My idea.
let's make it, because we'll get more. Let's do it positive or negative.
All right.
Best customer service email.
All right, that's a good idea.
Yeah.
Dude.
All right.
Because I have people that email me consistently, and they're like, I just want to say how much I love your customer service. You guys are so good, blah, blah, blah. And I just wrote back, like, thank you. Yes, we have good customer service. So maybe somebody will write something really, really fucking
I get a lot of good emails.
Yeah, like, so let's...
I pass them around whenever I get them.
And if there's an asshole-y one, we'll post that as well.
Yeah. All right.
So the best email of all time is the first yes email to entice.
For dice, yeah.
And you look at that email, the longer you look
the
at
girl,
it.
The girl, the orgasms?
No.
That girl?
We have framed
that's
her.
The best
it's
email.
Framed in there.
In my opinion, that's the best email. The girl that was like, I came 7 times or whatever the fuck she said, which was like, I felt like the girl was lying.
Yeah.
You're right. And multiple orgasms are possible.
No, she was like, Entice is the best product ever. I came, and then I came again, and then I came like 5 more times.
This was the first.
And she was like, I couldn't stop coming, the girl said, literally.
This was the first, yes.
So it's from Kirito Sal. It says, I want fuck your ass. What's better about it is there's a subject line. Yes. The subject line is, hey.
Hey, just out of curiosity, if you're paying attention, I would love to fuck your ass.
The very first one, number one, that's it.
I'm hoping that this is directed towards Kendra Lost or Celeste and not PJ or the rest of the customer service guys.
I came out, I just heard someone saying that a woman couldn't stop coming. What do you guys
So think? Listen, I showed it. I showed it to David. I showed it to a few people. This girl, the subject line was, entice is amazing, right? And then she wrote, I came within a matter of seconds, and then I came again from oral. And then during sex, I came so many times that it became uncomfortable. And she wrote, I can find it. She wrote, I literally couldn't stop coming. This product is incredible. And I was like, can you post this on your Instagram?
Effective product, dude. I think we have always, right?
I was like, I didn't even know what to say. I like showed it to Celeste, and she was like, that girl's a whore. And I was like, maybe. Maybe so, but I made that whore's life a lot better, right?
Hi, everybody. Hi. Hi. Hi, kids.
How are we doing this? How is
I don't
this
know. I'm Jewish.
I'm super new to this.
So I don't know what happened. My people, we do 8 days of guilt.
There's no guilt.
There's no guilt. So
it's the worst Hanukkah party ever.
So I'm doing the best that I can for you Gentiles. And I don't know what happens now. So we're all in a room and we have Secret Santa.
Yo, what did you get that comfy ass with?
This baller. Gucci home.
Who got that?
Eric got me that. I think I actually got the best one of the bunch.
It is the Secret Santa. I do know that Krampus wants to murder most of us.
That was good, Krampus, sir.
So, what's very funny is that I found this fucking stupid book, right? The Secret Santa asks people what you want your gift to be. And I feel like it's kind of asshole-y to say, like, get me this. So I found this ridiculous book. And I thought that, like, I would put it in there and it would turn anybody off. But it's called Bear Reality. Right, here it is. And it's just like 500 pages of naked chicks. But like, not chicks that you want to see, just naked chicks boobs. So whoever my Secret Santa is, who is my Secret Santa?
Not me.
Does anybody want to come forward? Who was it? You got the book. Just so everybody knows, I didn't really want this book, I was just being stupid. Thank you.
Well, you rolled the one person.
Thank you, Grant. Trust me.
Chris Heron, open your gift.
Damn it.
Yes.
Yeah, I don't got one.
There's like 20 people in the office who know what I got apparently, and I've been dreading this.
That's a great gift.
You're guaranteed to like it. I'm with Crash dressing.
I was half hoping for an
well, it's sent to Eric Young. Oh God. Anybody have a knife?
I offered you. Remember that time she just yelled, funny how shipping
comes out? Shipping clicks out a bunch of blades, like, don't fuck with us.
Yeah. Shipping guys
cut you open.
Unless you're trying to stab them. Yeah, but it's closed.
It's like they're walking down dark alleyways at night, other people are scared, they're like, no, I work in shipping.
Uh-oh. Get ready. What's it gonna be?
Oh, it's a Chipotle gift card.
In a huge box?
Yeah, and something wrapped. Hold on. Wait a second, is that the one off my desk? Where'd David go?
Oh God.
It's
Lewis.
Wait.
What is that?
Favorite comic book shop.
No. Hold on. I'm starting to...
Wizard's Tower, tell me the inside joke with Wizard's Tower.
No, it's getting better. I know what it is. Okay. Already. He grabbed all my own shit. Should we tell them the real irony? So, these are all my shirts out of my own laundry.
How did he have access to all your stuff without you knowing?
You know how I did it? Remember the other day you said it'd be impossible for Clay to go over the house?
Yeah.
He actually did it.
Are you kidding? The day before you said that, I had just gone into your room and stolen all that shit. Because the other day, I had this on my desk, and I had three of them. And there were two left, and I'm like, did one of you guys take my Chipotle card? And Dave's like, no, why would we do that? Now I know.
But in the end, you actually got something, right? You got a...
You got something
outside of your own stuff, you actually get something.
And for the record, that's not your Chipotle card. It's actually mine. You're just bitching about it so much.
Oh.
There you go.
So you are next one Chipotle to be affordable.
Okay.
I got a taser.
Who's getting zapped first?
Bro, okay, I just wanted to point out, I explicitly wrote you're not allowed to tase me on your thing. You put it on his
taser?
Yeah.
You gotta tase somebody.
Who's now?
Who's getting tased?
Tase me, Chris.
A dollar of
fucking tase me, I'll take it.
No!
Can you wait? Again?
Give it to you in the chat. And then we jump all the way to December 27th because we were out of town. We had a very nice holiday in New York City.
Oh yeah, Eric, did you put any of that footage in?
PJ was just filming my face up close for a while when I gave him the camera, which is not what I wanted. He would.
That's what you guys want, though.
He would be like this, and then he'd be like, "Hey, babe, you're so pretty," but it would be like all the pores in my face, so I know he was like, I was not looking.
I know that's what you guys want.
$20 can save your life, but this is $100. He's going in! 5, 6, 7. Where's your wife? Where's your boyfriend? It's 2016. Okay. Do you have a credit card? Swipe.
Hey, what's he doing, man?
I'm only kidding. 1 minute, 6 hours.
Babe, what'd you volunteer for?
Hey, watch your hands. Watch your hands, big guy.
Oh, yeah. That's the husband. I see you, baby. Now, hey. Good thing that you showed me that's your wife, because you're next.
I looked you guys up already. What's up?
Whoa. What's up? That was for the show. This is for his shirt.
Okay.
Let's go, big guy. Do it again.
Let me make sure you clear it first.
All right, so are you a man of your word?
Of course.
$20 we clear, right?
Thank you. Working.
I'm only joking. Okay, sweetie, we're gonna put you in the front, but you cannot go in front of that guy.
Okay.
Right there in the end.
All right.
Squeeze his butt.
So we're on Broadway. We're about to hit Broadway.
On Broadway.
That's it? That's all you got for us?
No,
come here on the side.
I want to stand sideways so I look here.
I'm actually videoing you, which is funny. Are you doing the Buddhist crunch pose?
Okay, putting lots of footage in NYC. Not mine. I didn't even bring mine.
Yeah, bring yours.
PJ talks shit about my vape because he doesn't get anything out of it. Like high or nicotine or whatever.
I don't get the point of indulging in things that don't alter your mind state in some way.
I get it. So we're going to go to Sunglass Hut because I left my sunglasses at TGI Friday.
Yeah.
Unfortunately. Which was my plan, so I can get new ones.
We're also still trying to find shoes and Elmo, which there are numerous Elmos right there. And Spider-Man.
I'm gonna video you, keep going. I'm just right behind you.
Dude, I've never seen so many Elmos in one spot. Look, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 Elmos in one spot.
The stormtroopers are good too. Oh, there's two.
Which
there's
one
two.
Is the real one, though?
I don't know.
You only give $20 for the real one.
I know.
And then we even talked about my favorite scenario was, I really hope this made the cut, where PJ was like, what if I gave, because you know all the characters in Times Square, they're all dressed up as different characters. He was like, what if I gave all of them $1,000 to fight me? And then it turned into this scenario where they were just raping him.
It was just Muppets raping me.
Look at that bike gang, babe. They look dangerous. Gang. They're fucking dangerous.
How funny kids. Is that? Imagine if you were a part of it. Champs. Fuck yeah.
Found
imagine
it?
Imagine if you were a part of an actual Champs. Bicycle gang instead of a bike gang. Holy shit.
Oh my god.
Whoa.
Jesus Christ. Should we get a picture of them?
Yeah.
Come on.
Batman 2, everybody's
oh my god, there's a Smurf over there. Fucking Smurf.
You know what would be awesome? If we were like, look, here's $1,000. I want to fight every character that you can think of. You have to all attack me at once. And you got a video of me getting like ransacked by like Batman Smurfs.
But they were raping you, and I was like, stop. And I'm crying and shit, and they were just raping you?
But I was like defending myself like with as much honor as possible.
We found a Champs, not a Foot Locker, and they were not open because it is Christmas Day. So PJ's goal is to find shoes. So.
We're on a bus ride up here.
We're on a mission. Find some fucking goddamn Nikes for this guy. We might just rob someone for their Nikes. Hopefully they're a size 11. We just turned on the street. It's like a little sketchy. It seems like weed, doesn't it?
definitely smells like
There's
weed.
There's a lot of places that smell like weed.
Everywhere smells like weed now.
There's another McDonald's.
We've passed 17 McDonald's.
There's another near sports pub across the street.
We should definitely, we should really work out. We're fat fucks. We didn't even, we didn't do cardio today.
Nope. Well, we're kind of in cardio.
We're doing cardio now, see?
We've walked a lot. You have said we have walked a lot.
December 27th, Celeste showing new men's leggings and jeggings.
We got our jegging samples in, which have been a big, cool project we're working on.
Very cool.
With someone very special. And then the men's leggings, I've had like 20 million samples made because I still felt like they weren't right. And I feel like this one we nailed. We just have to make sure we have the right fabric and threads, and we're going to finally get the men's leggings in production. These are pretty sick, though. Did you see them on the guys the other day?
Ooh.
Good, right?
I like the highlight.
I like the stitching. That's what I wanted to do is like, and on the, we're going to do the black and white camos with the orange.
What's the material like?
So, after these bucks, I spent months trying to get them to tell me what they liked. Mm-hmm. And we just, you remember it was a smoother, thinner
yeah, it
fabric?
Was more like the first.
Yeah, one. And then they wore them, the women's leggings, the Heather ones, on Halloween to the Snapchat takeover. And they were like, oh, this fabric's so soft. And I was like, Jesus Christ. I have been asking you guys for months. So then I got the samples made in the Lunars, and everyone likes them. So here are the jeggings. Yes. Even though these are way lighter than what I thought. So they have a little button, zipper, boom, scrunch. Cool, right? Yeah, they're like regular like pants. They kind of look like a little bit like corduroy. Here's the blue ones, like true denims. A little belt loop. These are supposed to be like way better than Freddy's. Just because we made them. Okay. Let's see. I don't know why I have these. And these are just versions of the crop top that we already have. Okay, that's not important. Cool, right? I'm gonna
go those are nice.
Try these on later because you can. You could, I mean, technically work out in these because they're like a,
Do they have pockets?
They're denim jersey. Stitching? No, the reason we don't have pockets is because, I don't know why we don't have them in the front, but in the back is because it would get, distorted from the scrunch.
Yeah.
So I'm so excited about these. All right, cool.
Very exciting. We've got some, studs lined up to model those. December 28th, there was a marketing meeting with Celeste, David, and Clay. You guys will see a little bit of that.
That's the best lie slash story you could tell me.
What do you think happened?
It was like, I'm assuming that you're right-handed. Maybe it was like a jerk-off accident. Somehow.
Everybody says that. I'm
okay. Guys, oh, I knew that. I did know you're left-handed. I've talked about that before. Then I don't know.
But you know the people who are advanced in the masturbatory arts use the offhand because it feels more like a stranger's hand.
First of all, why is no one laughing at the masturbatory arts? That is an amazing thing.
We talk about this all the time. It's not a joke, but it's real.
I always thought it was, well, PJ uses his non-preferred hand because he had an injury one time, I think. And he switched, and then he stayed.
I think that's how I switched too.
You had like a bicep, because PJ had a bicep there.
I've been lefty for a while.
Yeah, that's what. I'm pretty sure that's how he switched. Anyway.
Pricing. What do we want? So we're doing, basically, like, are we just doing the whole, like, increase everything $10 plan?
I kind of want to stagger it. Let me get my computer because I want to look at it while we're talking about it. I really only want to focus on the things that,
that move a lot, right?
And that we're keeping. Like,
yep.
So.
So we need your tag sticking out.
What if she wanted the bags to be?
No. So the only thing that we changed is the high-waist charcoal, the new black, and the joggers just because they were new. I mean, the low-rise are already like $80. Into 70, 75. I know they have stuff for 80.
Yep.
But their stuff is very cheap, cheaply made.
And we should definitely be going. We're getting to the point now where, yes, we're getting our stuff made cheaper, but it's going to be the same quality, hopefully. Mm-hmm. See what the samples are like. But we still have more room to increase the top.
Also, random flowers were sent to Salvina. And we found out she had a secret admirer.
Okay.
You fancied it up in here.
I did. Did you see this?
Is
this?
Is somebody playing a prank? They have to be.
Can't wait to tell our dance to be hurt. That's really funny. Oh,
all right. good. I'm
here. I know who it is.
Shorts, the side ties sell like crazy. You? So I have this one on kind of too.
I'm an asshole.
You should have saw the guy. Dude's like, you don't know anything about flowers. So it's like, look, just because I have tits and a vagina, I don't dig about flowers, okay?
Oh,
they
amazing.
Come in colors, they smell
that's
sometimes.
That's so funny.
We also got our Forever Young IVs delivered here that day. I like to get the IVs brought to the office rather than go to the doctor's office. It's a great service that they provide at Forever Young. I love that.
And also everyone likes it because it forces PG to sit down for an hour and like not move anywhere. So it's very hard to get his attention. Yep. Even me, I have to schedule an appointment with Salvina to like have a meeting with him at work. I need a skull in my shirt.
Get one of the Blackstone shirts.
What's his name? It's
is that the Four Dishonor shirt?
Is it Kearney?
Hmm?
We have a shirt with a skull on the front.
Yeah, that's what I said. The...
Okay, I'll do that. I'll do it.
I can drop the most random.
Jimbo! How did I not know that? I'm embarrassed. I've been watching Simpsons my entire life. Jimbo Jones. Oh. Can you take a picture of me staring at this? So,
busy guy. But yeah. Celeste got me a goat phone case.
Have you even used it?
Once.
I'm using it right now with Live.
It is not on my phone right now.
It's stuck up against a Hype bottle.
How about that?
And then I gave Trevor the other one that didn't fit my phone, and I think he's been using it. Anyways, the goat phone cases, they're not adhesive and they're not magnet. It's just made this weird material and it sticks to like almost any metal, like refrigerator,
space age
glass. It's like technology. It's alien shit.
That'd be really sad.
He like a tennis ball. Ooh.
What'd I do?
Ooh.
It's a goat case.
Bad.
Next box, goat.
Bad.
Goat.
Oh, so, like,
wait.
You can film yourself at the gym or, like, jerking off.
Oh, is it
wow.
Magnetic?
Yeah, that's what I do. Isn't it enough to replace what you already have?
So what does it stick to?
So you just put it on your phone, and then you peel this cover off,
uh-huh.
And it's just got,
like some kind of adhesive?
It's not sticky because it would, like, stick to everything, but it's, like, it's weird how it sticks to, like, feel it.
Would you trust it on the edge of a dam?
I trust that. Remember where my computer was sitting? Oh. I trust it anywhere.
Okay.
All right.
So, Trevor, show us.
Cool, right?
That's
ooh,
great.
It's that's like awesome.
Metal services,
oh, so it's like magnetic-y.
The Lewis Hall no,
that's on wood.
Oh.
A bee's.
It's weird. Here,
it feels
science.
Feel it. So, I ordered these, and then I freaking got a new phone and it doesn't fit.
Is it? Oh, that's like stuck on there.
Yeah. Let me see.
That's stuck there. That is...
We're in the fucking future.
Like stuck.
We're in the
like...
Why you give me this case and say get me an iPhone 7?
It might stick your phone to your drone and just take it off.
Whoa,
why is it like?
It's so, the company's called Goat.
Is that kind of not coming off?
What the fuck?
Isn't that cool?
It's like,
you can videotape yourself.
It's like,
oh.
Yeah, that's what it's like. I've seen a lot of people at the gym with it.
Shit's not moving.
So if that breaks, I'm suing them. Tell
him
straight
up. But Mike can't even get it off. It's not gonna fall and break.
Are you sure?
And you can put it anywhere?
So,
isn't there talking
mirrors, glass, ceramic tile, metal, whiteboard, wood, and leather.
Oh, this shit is crazy.
So basically anywhere.
Wow. Maybe go for it.
So this all was going down on a Wednesday, by the way.
It's because it's barbershop.
And it happened to be barbershop Wednesday, and we talked about our old label designer, how crazy he is, and the original story. You guys are actually going to see the original story of how the Angel Dust label was designed on here, so I think you guys will appreciate that. That's old school stuff.
Because the guy that used to do the labels back then was like a drug addict, bad.
right? So I explained to him what I wanted on the label, right? And I explained it via email. I have a vision of like this sexy angel that's just sprinkling the dust, like a pixie fairy, like from Peter Pan. I'm like, but sexy, and I want it just to be like a silhouette of her body. And he literally made, like, he took like the sexy part too far. So the first angel had like really big tits, but you could see her nipples and shit. And like you could see her vagina. And I was like, dude, you can't have a naked girl on the cover of the bottle.
Don't have vaginas.
And he was like, I thought you wanted it to be a sexy angel. And I was like, no, it's like a penthouse angel. I was like, tone it down.
Sexy.
So he was like, he was just making her like darker. And then the best part was, so like when I had said that I wanted her to be like sprinkling the dust, now there's like a pile of powder on the label. Like, we didn't ask for that. I was like, did he put like a pile of coke like, on the label? Because that's what it looked like in the first label. And he was like, oh, I thought that's what this shit does, right? Like, it gets you fucking cracked out. And I was like, you know what? That's so funny. Just leave it. And Aaron was like, yeah, let's leave it.
Yeah.
And then so then finally, I had to actually send him pictures because he was kept making the girl like too slutty and naked. And I was like, no, picture if she had like a leather suit on, like the Gimp from Pulp Fiction.
Yeah.
And I sent him like a clip of the Gimp from Pulp Fiction. So he made it all like leathery, and I was like, no. And then finally, I actually took, it's Dorian Yates' wife, Gall Yates. Chris Zimmerman did this photo shoot with her where she's like standing like this. And I was like, dude, take this picture of this girl. Actually, this may get him in trouble. No, I don't think it will, actually. I was like, take this picture of this girl from Chris Zimmerman did it. I was like, and just make it completely black. So it's just a silhouette and then add angel wings to it. And he was like, that's it? And I was like, yes, no more of the naked girls on the bottle.
Yeah.
And so then he did that and I was like, perfect, that's what we wanted. So it literally took like 8 exchanges via emails of me getting mad, and then finally after the 8th email and Aaron being like, dude, this guy's like a drug addict, he's retarded, you gotta like get him on the phone, I called him on the phone, I like walked him through what I wanted, and then he was like, leave the pile of coke, and I was like, yes, leave the pile of coke, just change this to the girl. I was like, and don't call it coke either, it's just angel dust.
I love that it says cut with.
Yeah.
That was the first thing I noticed on it. I was like, this makes this more hardcore than this shit.
We wanted it to be like, because I would tell people, like, they'd be like, what do you take? And I would like, dude, I take fucking 3 scoops of Jack. It's like fucking crack. And like I would hear kids in the gym be like, oh, I'm fucking cracked out. Shit's like speed, you know. And I was like, I wanna make ours like have like a drug reference, but I want to be like funny about it. And, like, because I don't think most young kids will even know what angel dust is.
Right.
They probably have heard of PCP or like maybe heard of angel dust, but it's not like a commonly like talked about drug.
No.
I'm like, also, since we're gonna have the actual angels on the label, it's like a total play on the words. Like, it's not.
Yeah.
So it's like, hey, this is a drug, but no, it's not. That was like the whole thing that I wanted, but adding the actual pile of coke like made it. Like, you know what I mean?
It's like you go either way.
Yeah, that's what we wanted though. We wanted people to look at it and be like, what is this?
Totally safe for him, like that.
Yeah, exactly. that label was probably the hardest label to get right because of how retarded that kid was.
What was he into?
Also, sometimes he invoices me and he has not worked for us since Grant has worked for us, which is how long? 2 years?
Yeah.
So he will send me PayPal invoices out of nowhere. It'll be like 2 a.m. and it'll be for like something crazy, like $14,000. And I never respond to any of them. I'm like, what the fuck? I used to show them to Aaron, and he'd be like, he's probably on drugs. I just ignore them when I get those.
Yeah.
But yeah, he would send PayPal invoices for like $8,000, like things that should be like maybe $500. And also things that like he didn't even do. Like just invoicing us.
So, hey guys.
Like, yeah, you owe me $14,000.
I need some of this
like
money.
You haven't worked for us in 2 years.
I'd really like this money just for no reason. It'd be cool.
Yeah.
Here's my invoice. Please complete this.
And Laurin Conlin being signed.
Yay!
To Celestial Bodiez. We're very, very excited about that. So she's been with Blackstone for a year, but she was with another clothing line, so we couldn't sign her. But once her contract with them expired, she really wanted to be with Celestial Bodiez, and now she's with us.
And
we're very excited.
Side note about Laurin, she's got to like extremely cool mom.
Very cool mom.
Her mom rocks Celestial Bodiez too and looks amazing.
Very cool parents. Her dad's a former NFL football player.
She's like
badass.
Lauren was like born into coolness.
Yeah, and genetics.
Hey! We're talking about Girls Media Videos.
And stuff. Oh, sweet. I look
Uh-oh. What's up, Jimbo?
I look
Girls Media Videos. Good.
Dude, your Simpsons fucking memes are killing me.
You were away, weren't you?
I was. Where have I been? Everywhere. I'm always
where
somewhere.
Have I been?
I feel like I'm
Who
always
am
somewhere.
I?
Okay, so we have some silly stuff. This was just. I had to buy this for you.
Why would you fucking send that to me?
Because
oh my god.
This is fabulous. It's just a wine thing.
This is amazing.
But it matches your house.
I love it.
I was like, I have to get this for Celeste. And then this is for me and mom. You're gonna laugh really hard.
Your mom texted me earlier. I haven't even opened it yet. And you guys are too sweet. I didn't know you were coming today.
Yeah.
How long are you guys gonna be in the area, and are you for the holidays? Like,
yeah, I'm just
anywhere?
Here until this weekend. So she was texting you to see if we could do lunch tomorrow because I'm gonna be.
Oh shit.
Let me just, I haven't even opened it yet. With my accountant tomorrow.
Yes, let me tell her so I don't seem like an asshole. Well, yeah, totally. Tomorrow's what, Thursday?
Yeah, I think.
This is amazing. Honestly, this could not have gotten any better this moment. This is amazing.
Thank you, so,
I'm going to send her a picture of it.
Wait,
thank you.
So sweet. We were like, oh, you taste it. We were like, this is amazing. Then we were like, we have to get Celeste her.
Okay. Thank you very much. How was your trip?
It was good. There's really good pasta in Italy.
Clearly.
So. No, it was really fun. It's so different over there.
Like what, people?
Like the culture? Everything. Yeah, like everything about Italy. Well, I mean, obviously, but Europe is just so different.
Also, they like don't really like love Americans.
No, they're really rude, yeah. Sorry to all the Italian people watching this.
Okay, so I'm just American. Let's confirm. I'll confirm with your mom.
They're still upset over World War II.
And you can move all of that shit. It's just... It's not so people don't sit down, it's just because I'm lazy and I moved the clothing rack out of here. And I don't
have to say, where is it?
It's in Rossi's snack rack, and I'm gonna like redo it. Mm-hmm. We're gonna paint it and all the clothes, the
I was gonna say, there's a whole bunch of new stuff too, right?
Yeah, we'll run back there and
That's
do you wanna do any videos this week?
I know that y'all were real busy.
We were listening to some country on the way
out, I say y'all all the time.
Oh no,
people make fun of me.
I get made fun of all the time. I always think I'm like every country song sounds like lang, lang, and so
it does.
Now
it's so cute.
Right? I love it.
It's amazing.
And look at the wine bottle. I like Apothic. I haven't tried that one. But in any case, the bottle is fabulous because it's just like, I don't know. Just pretty. So.
Oh yeah,
so
it
even
is.
If you don't
like the name. I like the name.
Mm-hmm.
That's a cool name.
Eric, isn't this so exciting?
Eric, listen. Some of the stuff we do is exciting. Most of it is not.
Honestly, no, I'm surprised that you still want to be friends with me after last weekend's videos.
I don't know if I have as much money.
Oh my god. Did you tell?
I didn't tell her yet. That was so
okay.
Funny.
So Eric's redoing my website. Right. And I'm really awkward with stuff like money and talking about things, and especially with friends, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And so we had just talked about like, oh, you can do the site and whatever, and my mom kept asking me like, how much is this gonna be? Like, you need to like finalize these things. It's like a business, like business talks. And I'm like, oh, it's, you know, I'll talk
I'm
to
the
Eric.
Worst with that too.
I was like, I'll talk with Eric, you know, like we're friends. And then I was like, oh, by the way, because he came down to like film some stuff for the site. I was like, by the way, how much is this gonna be? And then I obviously misheard him, and I thought he said $8,000 that he told me. And he's like, you know, I saw Gorilla site, and you know, I thought, you know, blah blah. And he's the guy, whatever, and this and that. And I'll give you this. And I was like $8,000. I was like, wow. And I like got really awkward for like 5 minutes, and like kept like kind of going back and forth. And then he's like, well, I'm gonna help you do this and this. And I was like, I just should have clarified first. I guess I didn't know how much. I was like, can we do like a payment plan? And he's like, looking at me like, all right. And then he's like, Laurin, I said $800. I was like, no, because then I was like, $8,000 is just like a lot of money. And he's like, I said $800.
That's really amazing. That
get this in the show.
Naturally.
the penis.
We saw it immediately. We were like, we have to get this. Me mom got Celeste penis pasta from Italy.
Isn't that awesome? Okay, whatever. I'm not gonna get any cleaner than that.
My mom's pretty crazy. So
that's fantastic.
Seriously, best gift.
Right? How amazing.
Signature page fudge. Okay. It's not me. I'm not PJ. Okay.
we just film you signing it in the wrong spot.
I'm gonna get your hair in there.
You're drawing little penises now.
Okay, all right,
it's over. Gotta sign it. That's cool. So crazy.
Yay!
Whenever I
witness contract signings, I always think of when
they're just like laughing
Ursula.
At her.
When Ariel gives up her voice to Ursula via contract.
So that makes you Ursula. Then. Yeah,
it does, which I don't mind because I fucking love Ursula. So.
And then finally, to close the video out, we had a race of drones, and we called it Game of Drones, aka Drone Wars.
Yeah.
And there were three people who brought their drones to work to have a race around the warehouse.
Instagram Live day.
We did Instagram Live, and my phone died, of course. Story of my life.
Plus, all of them.
I think yours looks a little easier to control.
Yeah. I want to try yours.
Here, see if you can control mine.
Well, I'll do it in the warehouse. I don't want
to
do it.
All right. Yeah, mine I've got it down.
They will do it.
He's gonna run me. He's gonna run me.
Look at this control.
It's really good.
It's got like fire triggers where you can shoot people and shit.
It shoots things?
No, why is that triggers?
To switch modes.
Yeah, mine has triggers too, see?
Mine has
R1, L1, though.
I have a flip and a flight mode.
I mean, he's got that
mine has a
buttons that make a U-turn, or buttons just to make it like do it like a half turn.
I have a gnome pin in my office.
Alright, so
I crash in a heartbeat. I crash so fast.
Yeah, for like 3 seconds.
Yeah.
So what I try to do is two.
Like three.
There's mine value in Facebook.
Like, is yours the one? That I specifically
his is the favorite.
He has the murder drone. Yeah.
He's got an X-wing.
Vegas has the money on him for sure.
Did anyone name the drones?
But I no.
Like, murder drone.
I named the event a game of drones.
Oh shit, that's good. So then shouldn't they be named after like characters that I don't know any? Can we just call Chris Herons Khaleesi?
It's not Khaleesi. It's been dubbed.
It looks like a dragon. Other ones now. I don't know.
100 bucks goes to the winner.
Alright. We need a countdown from somebody.
Three!
We got a follow.
No, my phone just died!
Story
of the battery case!
Ready? Two more
people. We're gonna start?
Alright.
Don't start without me. I'm just plugging my phone.
Quick, let me get a quick charge.
Five, four, three, two, one. I like the commentary, but I feel like babe, you're probably gonna like run into something.
Your air is fucking up.
Chris, very calm, collected. Mike still has a
problem. Mike, no, his died, babe.
Oh, his died. He probably loses by default then, I guess, right?
No.
This is where it gets very challenging back here. Oh, it's very dangerous to navigate, as I stated earlier. I believe we have had reset. The skinny guy on Twitter. That's for Taryn, yes. That's why I'm on the board, Taryn. So they're in like
oh, fuck.
It's very close. Yeah. Oh, here comes Chris Herons, though. We see it. Oh, it looks like Chris Herons, I think. Wait, no!
Brett didn't go all the way.
So who is the official winner based on rules there? Yeah. Chris Herons, right? Oh. Very close. unfortunately.
Mike died.
Man, if it would have started, I would have been one.
Rubs.
So that was just
died? Brett, did yours just die?
Oh, I'm like, where is Mike?
That was actually pretty funny.
Chris Herons gets $100 on it. And by the way, I
anything involving like gadgets and computers, I always vote on Chris Horton. Always vote on Chris.
You're like, yours like cheated and like flew through the middle of shit. Like, what is he doing?
And then he did the engine kill.
All right, guys, I am going to shut this down. It's
Game of Thrones. That was like a real like Star Wars
party. I want to see the camera.
One dead in the beginning, everyone else.
How did you feel about Drone Wars?
I was very
Game of Thrones. Were you disappointed? But the winner was Chris Herron, as he is always the winner in computer and tech related things.
True. But Mike's died, his battery died. So I feel
he
like
lost by default.
Very anticlimactic because Mike had the coolest one. It looked so sick. It was like an attack drone.
Looks can be deceiving though. Don't judge a book by its cover.
Ain't that right?
Yeah. So I think that you guys will appreciate watching the Drone Wars. It's a fun place to be here at Blackstone Labs, and
we need to do a drone rematch.
We will absolutely, because Mike needs another chance. So this is our first Beauty and Braun of 2017.
Woo!
Very exciting.
Instagram lived it.
Thank you to Werewolves for making our music. Hey, that's the new music. We love those guys, and we will be pumping out the Beat PG contest like crazy over the next week. So make sure you guys look out for how to enter that $5,000 for first place. And then start paying attention to Celestial Bodiez because they're going to be transformation contests over there too.
Transformations left and right.
Giving stuff out, just giving shit out like crazy.
Yeah, so we're excited to not be fat anymore.
I am.
We've just been disgusting like in every aspect. We have still been training though.
Yes.
So.
And having sex when we can. I would like to tonight,
okay.
Please.
We just set a date.
All right.
On that note, I'm going to end this.
Peace out, bye.
Thanks for watching, guys. Peace out.